الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله لقد جاءت رسل ربنا بالحق سبحانك يا ربنا لا نحصي ثناء عليك أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك نستغفرك ونتوب إليك وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو حي لا يموت بيده الخير وهو على كل شيء قدير وأشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله أرسله الله على فترة من الرسل فأدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة ودعا إلى الله وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله الغرب الميامين وأصحابه نجوم الدين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وعنا معهم برحمتك أرحم الراحمين عباد الله اتقوا الله يقول الله تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. I have met with an American Muslim and he said that the Muslim nowadays, they are busy in criticizing each other, you know, about how to put their hand while praying, or how to put their feet and you name it, you know. I'm not here to put these issues down, you know. These are part of our fiqh and the Prophet did teach us, you know, many of these issues, you know. But this is what was not the main part of his message, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. His main part of message was what he spent 30 years, you know, establishing it in Mecca al-Mukarramah. Namely, what has been highlighted, وَدَاعِيًا إِلَى اللَّهِ بِإِذْنِهِ. This is one of the main tasks of the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to call everyone to Allah. That American person, he told me, perhaps if they are speak about the Qur'an, will be much more beneficial. I told him, I may correct your statement and say, if they speak and call people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the Qur'an is one of the maneuver to call people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to attract people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is our main task, you know, this is to be recognized as a Muslim among the others, you know, you should have different relation, you should have different look. If the other they stay with their food, with their other items, you know, you should be of higher state, you know, in that regard. And the Prophet ﷺ spent all of his life, you know, speaking up about these matters, you know. If you look at the most significant turning point in the life of the Prophet ﷺ, it is when Sayyidina Jibreel came to him in the cave of Hira, telling him, اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق. And this is, firstly, it's spiritual, not physical. Secondly, it is to show the relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when we declare that we are followers of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we should take significant care, you know, about these issues, you know. I'm sorry to tell you, nowadays the Muslims, they are much more interested, you know, about finding their way to make their life the physical life. Because the life, for sure, when you fix up, you know, your spiritual and your relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to be much, much, much better, you know. But they just look after the physical needs that they want in this life, bypassing that I am Muslim, I am follower of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did say, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنٌ. When you look at the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, physically, some days he may feel his stomach, the other days he may be left, you know, hungry, you know, all the time. Bearing in mind, he has everything available. When he immigrated to Medina al-Munawwara, he has jafna sa'd ibn ubada. Jafna, not like our dishes or plates. It may contain a camel, you know. Every day comes to the house of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yet we read in the seerah and in the hadith that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam may spend days and days, you know, hungry without eating. they were available physically for him, yet he has something in his mind which is much higher. When he spoke, you know, about Isra and Mi'raj, the other, they limited themselves, you know, to speak, you know, about the caravans and how they travel. When he spoke, you know, about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and how this was revealed for him, the other spoke that this person wants to compete with us, you know, in this life to be a leader or to be richer or to have much more better position or whatever, you know. And he spent many of his time, he was challenged by many persons, you know, in that limited, narrow sight that they have to this life, you know. And the Muslim, by no way, by no means, he should have this limited, narrow look, you know. He should firstly fix his way with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is maybe felt by some Muslim or others, you know, that this is only for the highly sophisticated people or the specialized one. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in two of his khutbah of Jum'ah, he highlighted it. When I say khutbah in Jum'ah, it means that this is for the common people, for everyone. He should find his way. He should improve his relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He should have something better. He should improve himself every day. I'm telling you, physically, if I want to improve myself every day, it's almost impossible. But spiritually, to improve my relation with Allah, it's quite, not quite possible. It's the case. This should be the way. This should be my attitude toward Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I should feel myself as a slave or servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm getting closer and closer. I'm improving myself. I have better relation. I have better understanding, you know. I have better relation with the Holy Quran. My prayer is going to be much better, you know. But when this Ramadan is coming to me, it's going to be much more different than the previous Ramadan. Physically, maybe the same, you know, from dawn till sunset, you know, and refrain eating and drinking, you know, but it's going to have different meaning, different taste, different experience. And that's what the Prophet ﷺ highlighted for us. He keeps speaking about these issues, you know, and the other, some of these people, you know, I'm sorry to tell you, in his time, perhaps most of them, they were non-believers, you know, but in our time, many of the believers, they have the same attitude, you know, when you speak about some of these issues, they are going to speak, you know, about very silly, you know, and limited matters, you know, which doesn't fit, you know, being one of the followers of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In many verses in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described the Prophet as داعيا إلى الله, inviter to Allah. He wants everyone to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of his specialties, I'm not limit his specialties be Abi wa Ummi to this particular thing, you know, but one of his specialties, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, among the prophets, not among me, okay? We as Muslims, we believe that the best human ever, they are the prophets. And among them, the messengers, you know. These are the best, you know, among the whole humanity, you know. We don't care a lot, you know. We may care some, you know, about those who have some certain discoveries, you know, or certain improvement, you know, in their life, or this or that, you know. But the best, the top, they are the Prophet. And the top of them is our Prophet, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Why he is in the top, you know? For sure, there are many factors, you know, hidden that we don't know about them, you know, but there's quite obvious one, you know. He mentioned about it, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he said, on the hereafter, you have some prophets, you know, come with one person, two persons, three persons, you know, few persons, you know, and the Prophet, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is going to come with something, fill the whole horizon, you know, of people, you know. And this is by itself, it tells me how great is this person, you know, who lived only 63 years, you know. He had the revelation for 23 years, you know, yet he brought to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he brought to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the largest number of people with him, you know. Made all of these people, you know, familiar to Allah. They know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They have special relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They have full confidence in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They have complete reliance on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They have significant
Not by tongue, you know, I'm sorry. Yani, I got fed up, you know, because I keep hearing, you know, people, we love Allah, we love His Messenger. Love is practice, love is experience, you know. I don't see it in everyone, perhaps because I'm a bad person, you know, but I don't see it in everyone, you know, how they practice, how they experience their love to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how they experience their love to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's not a matter of speaking up about it. It's great to speak up about it, you know, to make it well known to everyone. I look at it as significant and positive point, but it's not the end of the story. I would rather look at it as the beginning of the story. Okay, after that, you should read about those people who were real lover of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who were real lover, you know, of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and then you try gradually to apply some of those matters, you know, to your life. Not because you are going to give benefit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no way. You are going to give benefit for yourself. You are going to make yourself as a humankind. I look at myself, you know, I'm not speaking about the other. If my aim and target in this life to eat, drink, and sleep, you know, my target is similar to the target of the animals. No difference. I may have a little bit more sophisticated way, you know, of eating, drinking, and but if this is the only target or the only aim I have in this life, there's no difference. I'm really speaking seriously with you, there's no difference. But I see my humility when I know more about my Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when I learn more, when I recite the Qur'an. These are the animals, not the animals, the angels, they are incapable, you know, of doing it. That's why they, when you start reciting Qur'an, they start calling each other, you know, to come and listen to Qur'an, okay? Yani here, you have some unique relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's in your hand all the time, okay? It's available for you. I would rather say, in our time, it's much more available than any time in the past, you know. I have come through, you know, and perhaps you are much more familiar with this, you know. Many programs, you know, may be put, you know, in the iPhone or iPad, you know, and by these programs, you know, you may find out, you know, the most famous reciters of Quran all over the Muslim world. When you have, you don't know how to pronounce one word, you know, of the Quran, you are going to be familiar with it, you know, by teaching you in this way. When you are, you don't understand certain meaning, or you have different language or whatever, it's going to be translated for you. This availability of the Quran, I'm telling you, it wasn't as such, you know, in the previous time. We should appreciate. This is one. We are drowned in the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is one of them. I'm giving you one example of it. I'm sorry to tell you, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told his companion that you are going to have a time when you have the food available for you, and you have a lot of clothes, you know, and you have servants, and you have this and that. They said, the companion, not us, they said, we are going to be better off, you know, in these days. The Prophet ﷺ kept silent for a while, then he said, no, you are better today. And they got surprised. How come, Ya Rasulullah, al-khayru ya'ti bishar, when you have something good, you know, something beneficial for me, is going to hurt me and harm me? Yes, we observe it in this life. Food is necessary for me. When I overeat, what's going to happen? Either I'm going to have hypertension, diabetes, or osteoarthritis, or get obese, you know, or lack of movement. You see, we see those exaggerations, you know, when you have certain practice, you know, you are going to see the harm in this life. But tell me about one person. He excessively loved Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and was hurted. Tell me about one person, you know, who excessively recited the Quran and he was hurted. Okay, you are not going to find anyone. And this is in this life, you know, in the you are going to find these people, you know, they are quite peaceful, quite happy, quite appreciating, you know, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given to them, you know. What did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say? وَلَا الْآخِرَةُ أَكْبَرُ دَرَجَاتٍ وَأَكْبَرُ تَفْضِيلًا. If you feel, if you observe that these people, I observe this, you know, personally, they are much better than me, okay? When I feel this, that's mean in the hereafter they are going to be much higher, you know. And the gap between me and them is going to be much more. Ya Sayyidi, this life is a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It was given to you to build up your relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have been told, you know, by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that some of the people, they may come in the hereafter. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save the whole audience, you know, of this position, you know, they are going to be reckoned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How come so and so, I gave you this amount of money, I gave you this amount of this and that. What did you do for me, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What did you do? And that person, in this critical position, was going to say, oh Allah, I kept all of them. If you want, just return me back, you know, and I'm going to bring everything to you. Now, time is over, my friend, okay. So I look at the whole audience, you know, you still have a time. You still have free time, you know, to mend your relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when Khutbah as narrated in Ibn Majah, he told the people, وَصِلُوا الَّذِي بَيْنَكُمْ وَبَيْنَ رَبِّكُمْ بكثرة ذكركم له وكثرة الصدقة في السر والعلانية تجبر وتنصر وترزق. That's me. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam telling the common people, he's not telling one who is special, you know, or that one is religious, or no, he's telling the common people who attend prayer, Jum'ah prayer, you know, telling them, mend the relation between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Personally, I don't know how to mend my relation with Allah, but the Prophet did tell us, you know, about it. How to mend our relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If I'm going to think, you know, about it, you know, thousand or thousand feet, I will say, what come to my mind, you know. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, make it, all of these matters, you know, make it quite simple, you know, and quite easy for everyone. And this is my surprise, you know, why I'm blaming myself, why I run away, you know, when it's that easy, you know, and to have relation with who? With Allah, not with a person. When someone, you know, some action, you know, is going to make him closer to some high figures, you know, or high authority in this life, is going to be proud of himself, you know, and feel himself better than the other. Here, in very simple way, very efficient way, very practical way, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tell you how to mend your relation with who? With Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How? You make plenty of zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is your benefit. You are going to get the maximum benefit with not Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what's that second item? The second item, not for you, not for Allah, the others, you know. You pay charity, you know, in the hidden and in the private and the apparent way, you know, to the others, you know. What's the outcome of it? As the Prophet said, تُجْبَرُ وَتُنْصَرُ وَتُرْزَقُ. It's me, you are going to be mended, you are going to be supported and provided. When I think, you know, about the result, you know, I cannot imagine any humankind at all look forward to have much more than these three items, you know, that have been mentioned in this particular hadith. And this is hadith not for so and so person or for, this is for common people. This has been addressed by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam for everyone, and we should have it as such. I beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make my relation with him tomorrow much better than today, and the day after much more than, and this should be the aim, this should be the target of everyone, you know, to improve his relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to do so. al
الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد عبد الله ورسوله خير نبي اصطفاه ورحمة للعالمين أرسله اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين عباد الله إن الله تعالى يقول يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون إن الله تعالى يقول إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد وارض اللهم عن ساداتنا ومواليه الكرام أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن سائر العشرة وعن أصحاب بدر وأحد والحديبية وعن أزواج النبي وعميه وسبطيه وعن المهاجرين والأنصار وعن الصحابة أجمعين والتابعين وتابع التابعين بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وعنا معهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم أصلح أمة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم فرج الكرب عن أمة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم اجمع على الهدى أمر أمة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم اغفر لأمة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم ارحم أمة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم رحمة عامة اللهم أعز أمة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم انصر أمة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم اجبر أمة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم أغث أمة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم يا من لطفت في خلق السماوات والأرض ولطفت بالأجنة في مفول أمهاتها لطف بنا ولسائر المسلمين في قضائك وقدرك لطفا يليق بكرمك يا أرحم الراحمين ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب يا اللهم يا مقلب القلوب والأبصار ثبت قلوبنا على دينك وارزقنا معرفتك وطاعتك وطاعة رسولك والعمل بكتابك وأمتنا على ذلك يا أرحم الراحمين عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون أقم الصلاة.